Hello and welcome everyone to Naruto Storm 4 League Playoffs Preliminaries Episode 2. I'm your host, Aurange, and with me, as always, is Burnerator.
Hello.
Hello. So, we had in the last episode, Kurenai versus Sound, and Kurenai has actually moved up there. So they will be moving on to fight Team Minato next week. Mm-hmm. So that's exciting for them. But today, in this episode, we will be having Hidden Stone versus Team Guy in the battle to see who will move on to face Team Asuba. So, yeah, it's going to be an interesting match. Team Guy has really had some struggles.
Yeah, they've been struggling a lot lately.
Yeah.
And it's going to be very interesting because they, even though they used PTS Gaara three times, I mean, they didn't really change anything apart from disabling Lee's tilt again. So we'll have to see if that helps.
Yeah, anything that's broken may not be fixed. So
yeah,
I'm not really sure.
Yeah, I honestly have a lot more confidence in Stone because it seems like they have a cohesive theory, apart from Guy, who seems to still be all over the place.
Yeah, like they have, they can get solid performances, but not all the time.
Yeah, it's consistency, and like if you know DBZ League or have dealt with DBZ League, consistency is king. Knowing exactly what your character will do every match is the best. That is the perfect way to view things. But I don't see Guy as consistent.
No, and like you said, that's a bit of an issue here. And even though Stone hasn't always been the most consistent either, I feel like they have done a lot more, they found a lot more solid, you know, strategies and builds for their characters. Mm-hmm. Whereas other than like Tenten and Lee and I guess now PTS Gaara, you know, they're still finding now that, oh, hey, look, it looks like PTS Neji's pretty good. It looks like Shippuden Neji's pretty good. And that's only been this last trimester. So, you know, I don't know. It's hard to say how solid they are. So, but yeah, so without further delay, I think we should just see how this will pan out.
Basically, it feels like Guy is still in the second trimester, whereas Stone is in the playoffs.
Yeah, so
comparatively. But let's get into the match.
Yeah, maybe Guy can do it.
Mm-hmm.
All right, round number one, we have Mu with Deidara and Han versus Tenten, Neji, and PTS Gaara. Shippuden Neji, that is. And right off the bat, very aggressive. Yeah. And chainmail from Tenten. Gonna counter Mu there for a minute.
Yeah, and but he's just wow.
Yeah, but this could actually perhaps be a problem for Deidara. Because I think Tenten has more projectiles than him. And
yeah,
I believe they're more frequent.
Wow. Yeah. He seems
and
to be doing
ultimate
really well right in our face.
Yeah, but if he spams ultimates and that,
oh my God,
it won't matter.
That would have been a really crazy combo with Yui's Jutsu.
Oh,
he
yeah.
Held her in place, and he would have hit with that if she had not used her sub.
Very true. Yeah. Eruption kick going to connect, and so far Stone has a sizable lead.
Yeah, very sizable.
Without even hitting with any ultimates or anything, and Tenten's out of subs, but she's gonna try to hammer on this damage to Deidara before charging in and charging up her chakra to do an ultimate.
Going to
will connect.
Yep.
Nice. She is like surprised. She's surprisingly good with those ultimates.
Yeah, she is. It's kind of weird. She does better with them at range, I think.
Yeah. Mu activates a sub log, his trap card.
Team ults?
And Yeah.
Will not connect.
Trying to dash in there. Ooh. Han actually stopping that aggression. Nice.
Stopping Tenten's aggression too. And already, I mean, Tenten has no green bar.
Yeah. And this is what more of what I was talking about when I was predicting Guy versus Stone, where Mu's ninja dash would be really helpful against Tenten. And it seems to be. And now finally someone besides Tenten is out. So this could go a little differently now.
Good. Seeing as how Mu seems to be a lot slower than Edge, but Mu's still out and Tenten's still out, so
yeah.
That's a thing.
She is doing some nice damage though.
Yep.
But it may be short-lived. And already, Team Guy looks like they're gonna take two caps here.
Yep. Pretty much, just a little bit more and they will be taking two caps.
Yeah. Well, I mean, the green bar is gone.
For Stone.
Yeah. And now, yeah, and they have no subs, so I mean, if Guy can close in here now, then that could be
that
really good
sub
for
charge.
Them. Yeah. And the Blasting Spears will connect. The ultimate will, too!
Wow, that was a nice little combo.
What I'm talking about. And Neji is actually bringing it back.
Yeah. It's now even.
Bad
but either
all.
Way, it's going to be two caps out of whoever's favor.
Unless Stone uses an ointment, then they could prevent that.
They could. They already used one, but they need to use another.
Yeah, they'll need to use another, and it. I don't know. There's. I feel like there's not much time for them to do so.
Yeah.
Yeah, I feel like. Yeah, they're out of the range now.
Yeah.
So yeah, two caps no matter what.
Team ult. Will connect.
Will connect! Yep. So, Stone's gonna take two handicaps into the next round, but Guy really did a nice job of actually bringing back that damage, which is mostly Neji. So yeah, really well done there. It was quite enough to actually win it.
Yeah, I love the concept of an atomic dismantling jutsu.
Yeah, it's a really cool concept.
Yeah.
Well.
But anyways.
On to the next round.
Mm-hmm. Two caps out of Stone's favor. Alright, and on to round two, we have the same lineup from Stone with two caps out of the favor versus PTS Neji and PTS Gaara. Should be an interesting match if PTS Neji and PTS Gaara can be aggressive like they are doing right
yep,
now.
Yep, like this.
Look at my god.
And I feel like Han needs to be really active here.
Yeah, he really
for
does,
Stone.
But the thing is, Mu and Deidara have been really... very active as of late.
Yeah.
Han.
Yeah. Interruption kick. I'm charging up chakra before dashing in and going to dash. Those birds will connect though. So that's the thing.
Yeah.
They're gonna need to really start trying to do some real damage here. Deidara could spam some ults maybe.
That would be great. They just need to at least get one cap.
Yeah.
I'm not sure that they'll be able to take out this combo because Gaara is slightly tanky. And
true.
Neji has a ton of damage on him. But
oh, there's an ult.
Able to do one cap worth of damage is great.
Yeah, it'll at least set them up for the next round.
Yep.
Oh, there's
that's going to hit. Thing is, it's not going to do much damage. There you go.
Yeah, but it's still decent.
Yeah, it's still decent. If he throws out, like, three more of them?
There's,
two more of them
yeah.
now. Maybe one more of them.
Definitely one more.
Well, oh. I'm talking about aiming so that they can't...
Oh.
They can't, like,
right.
make back it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I see what you mean now.
Yeah. Team ult!
There's team ult, but that's gonna get canceled.
I will say that Deidara has been way better with his ults.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's nice to see that. There's an ult threat from Gaara. Not going to connect. And, nice! Full combo there from Deidara. I don't know if he'll be able to keep that up, though. Open it from Gaara. Oh, that's gonna hurt.
He's gonna
hurt.
Do a ton. This'll finish
it! Oh my god!
Oh my god! It's because it's melee and the two caps out of the favor.
Yeah, that's like green bar.
That is a green bar right there.
Era, why did you dash in? Your tendency to dash in is what killed you.
Yeah. That's why it's a tendency. He likes to do it.
It's
anyways,
a battle tendency.
That's the best. See you in the next round.
Alright, and on to round three, we have Deira with Han and Hand Soap versus PTS Neji and PTS Gaara again. No handicaps on either side. So we have an even round three right here. Let's see how it goes. PTS Neji and Gaara were really aggressive in the last round, but Deira got some ultimates off, and well, the damage that they'll do is going to be a lot higher now, so let's see if that'll actually make the difference for them. But it's completely
ultimate.
Even right now.
Not gonna connect.
Oh! Ulting right into that rotation.
Yeah. That was really unfortunate for them that it ended right at their rotation.
Yeah. I had to waste the side. And the ultimate from PTS Neji not going to reach. One of the worst ranges for an ultimate. Other than with Hinata.
Yeah.
Wow, and using both supports at the same time.
Not quite a full combo.
No, not
but
quite.
But still, he's on fire.
Yeah. And here's Gaara. Not quite able to close in yet.
Kokomaki. And that jutsu does not connect.
Yeah,
actually.
The birds kind of like crisscross and just miss him. Sand shower will
connect.
Close to circle
on
though.
Fire again.
Yeah, in fuego. And there is an ultimate, and there is another ultimate. And he actually subs it. Ultimato.
It's an ultimato.
And doing some nice combos there, but getting subbed actually. Gatorai, I noticed a lot of his combos get subbed, and he doesn't hit with most of them. Once he actually does start hitting with them, his damage is.
Oh,
really
his damage
good.
Is great, yeah. But the problem is, like, most of them don't hit.
Oh, here's a team ult.
Going to connect, so that's nice.
Yeah. Here we go, let's see how much this does.
Art is explosive!
And the green bar is still barely there.
Yeah, barely. Just a little bit more damage and it'll be gone. But Deidara's out of subs.
Oh.
And gets hit.
Wow.
Wow.
What a play.
Yeah. Instantly switching out and then team ulting when he was being comboed. That was really intelligent.
Yeah. And now Deidara's gonna waste the sub.
Ultimate.
Going for an ultimate.
Going
this one with
connect.
An ass. Nice. Pretty even. And now Neji's gonna do some combos into Gaara with the
interruption
kick. Yeah, and. Oh! I thought he went away from there for a moment, but it was just an armor break.
Oh, they used an ointment for stone.
Yeah.
That's a thing.
But yeah, Deidara mainly staying out this time. Say what you want, but at least he's not doing badly. Like,
yeah, at least that's a thing.
It's not like, what was it, against Uchiha where he did, I don't know if it was Uchiha, it was against somebody where he did, like, nothing.
Yeah.
I think it was awesome, actually. So,
ultimate.
Yeah.
Oh, going to
this
connect.
Will connect and probably finish it.
I'm not sure. No.
No.
No, it won't. But still, I mean, dude. Really
yeah,
well.
And now finally Hanzo's
team
out.
Ultimate.
And Hanzo might be able to finish this right here. He is a lot more aggressive, typically. Oh, he gets out of there, though. Apparently
nice
less job. Aggressive than Deidara. And the birds finish it.
The birds will finish it, so that means Stone will take one cap out of their favor.
Yeah, only one cap, so not bad at all.
Mm-hmm. we'll see you in the next round. Alright, and on to round four, we have the same lineup from Stone with one cap out of favor versus Lee and Neji.
Wow.
Yes. A little bit of back and forth right here.
Yeah, Lee tried to ultimate immediately. And Han is not a bad matchup here for Lee. Because, I mean, he'll soak up the damage pretty well.
Despite the ultimate? Cap out of his
face. Oh! It is going to get soaked up, but still, good damage on that. Han charging up. Explosive circle. Well, the twin birds connected at least.
Yeah, still, I mean, he's on fire, and Han is kind of going ham.
Yeah, a little bit.
Ultimate, he's on the ground, but he still wants to hit with that ultimate.
Yeah,
he has yet to hit with that.
Wait a minute, though. Explosive circle actually gets stubbed. So, yeah, clashing there, and Lee actually counters. Notice that Lee is actually kind of intelligent with his counters.
Yeah.
Not bad at timing them. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, Hanzo charging up now, as is Lee. But, another explosive circle. This one will connect, and Lee is on fire again. Gonna do some more air combos here. And Stone has the sub advantage right now.
Yeah, but they don't have the chakra advantage.
No. I mean, not by much, but...
Neither of them really has any chakra, but Stone is doing a really good job of just making sure they're on fire.
Yeah. And there's an ultimate.
Not gonna connect, but...
Yeah.
Still on fire. Lightning Kunai did not connect. They tried to cancel that with Lightning Kunai.
Yeah.
Very interesting.
It would have been nice, but actually, I think it hit the wall.
Yeah, it did.
That's the trouble of the way that item tracks.
Yeah, that's very even now. Ooh,
yeah.
And again, on fire.
Clashing there. Oh, and Neji charging up to do
going
awakening.
Yep.
Let's see if he does anything with this.
Might be really interesting if he does, because he would counter Hanzo really hard.
Yeah. And it seems
switches
like so far... Yeah. Lee's gonna do an ultimate, but it won't connect.
Explosive circle.
And the interruption kick. No subs for
either side.
For either side. Oof. Oh, there's an ult.
Yeah.
I wonder. I mean, it's probably gonna be canceled now, right? The ultimate actually connected. Apparently not. I think as long as Neji is still technically awakened, his support will still probably chakra drain.
Huh. Yeah, there goes the awakening.
Oh, yeah, and wow, they did some real damage there.
Wow!
Sublog, and they're not going to be able to touch Lee for a couple more seconds.
The thing is, like, if Stone is able to finish this...
Yep.
They already had a cap out of their favor. This is just going to add another cap.
That's true. They could only take one more, so... Yeah. Couldn't have... I mean, the only way it could have gone better for Stone is if they didn't take a cap at all, but...
Yep.
Still.
Well done.
Nicely done. All right. On to round five, we have Datara with Han and Hand Soap again. Versus now Neji and PTSR, which is their last and final lineup. With final lineup.
so all of their hopes and dreams for playoffs rely on this lineup or die.
And it's not a bad lineup.
This lineup has to go through not only this lineup but two more.
Yeah, so that's quite the that's quite the responsibility for this team. I mean, it's a strong team, but I don't know if they can do that. And Datara now has no subs.
Yeah.
But still gets that full combo.
He is still ranged, so he can sit at no subs in the background.
As long as he actually stays back. like a good ranged character, right, Daedra?
Right, Daedra?
Right.
You're doing the combos, right, Daedra?
Fuck.
Man, this would be so lame if Guy just gets outranged.
It would be really lame. It would be a lame way to go out.
Yeah, it really would.
But I think, hey, at least Daedra is doing his job for once.
Yeah, for once. He's actually being aggressive with ranged, which is really rare.
Yeah, and maybe, he actually got out.
Maybe he really just needs 2-cap out of his favor. Maybe.
All the time.
All the time.
Wouldn't that be something?
Oh my god!
Oh,
seriously, Daedra?
Wow. Trolled. He's got trolled.
Fucking he's just trolled like, hard.
You saw him at the end of that ultimate, he's like, HA!
And again, no subs.
Yeah,
there you
he's
go.
Gonna
now the damage
now.
Train gets things off.
And uses well
sleep tag
interruption kick. And really, the amount of damage taken does not matter for first zone. This is ridiculous.
Yeah.
Oh,
it really is.
Okay, Gar actually dodges the. This is a shit show.
Yeah.
I'm not even gonna mince words. This,
this
is a fucking
this is
shit
showing
show.
Second lineup too. It's
yeah.
Its second lineup. My god.
Oh. Yeah, and I think if they use two ointments, they could get their green bar back, but it wouldn't last for long.
Yeah, it really wouldn't.
And there's one.
Fire.
No, it won't happen.
He's on
now.
Fire.
The fire is gonna deny it. Yeah, that's not good at all. I mean, Stone has no subs, so they could take this opportunity to do some damage, and it looks like they are. Full combo. Into a strike back. And Twin Birds. Oh, the ultimate hits instead! The ultimate was faster.
So basically what they did was, okay, so you can get hit with the birds, you can get hit with the ults, or you can sub one and not the others.
Yeah. Oh man. What a trap. He just played his trap card.
Interruption.
Right? And so did Daedra. He's always played his trap card. Ultimate!
That's why Kaio calls him the Trap Master.
Yeah. And it looks like Daedra will be out of the picture for a little bit now.
Oh, nope.
Air palm. He got palm from behind, I mean. But he's getting in there now. This might be it. If Neji can't keep him away.
Yep. Team ult!
Team ult.
Will connect.
Well, I mean, at least he didn't get finished with range.
Yeah.
So...
I still feel bad for Guy. Holy shit, dude.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean... Hey, it's great for Stone.
It is.
But, I mean, Guy... I really feel like they weren't ready.
Yeah.
Which is sad. But hey, there's always next season, and
yeah, there is.
PTS 1010. I mean, you know, she is a must for you guys next season. And I'm sure you guys know that. So, you know, that alone will be really good for you guys.
Yeah, Guy will be way different next season.
Yeah. So. Yeah. But yeah, congratulations to Hidden Stone. Very nicely done. Finishing it on a round 5. That's insane. But yeah, we'll see you in the next episode and the next match.
Hey everybody, I just wanted to say thank you so much for watching, and I hope you continue to enjoy Naruto League. Remember to check us out on the forums, where you can talk about the teams, the matches, lineups, pretty much anything relating to Naruto League. And of course, if there are any teams you're interested in joining, don't hesitate to go on over to the forums and sign up. Every person can be a huge help. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Take care, everyone.
We'll be right back. We'll be right back.